Hello friends, Doug Finke, 16-time Microsoft MVP. And today I'm going to take a look at my PowerShell Excel integration module. And we're going to take a look at how to pop this data into this sheet, set it up so that it gets nice headings, gets this bolding and colorization at the left, and then does this neat little trick of showing what's up, what's down, and what hasn't changed. So let's do this. We're going to build this, but we're going to do it step by step. So let's take a look at, here's the data. I'm just putting it in a here string in PowerShell, and I'm converting it from CSV and storing that data in the $data variable. Next up, I will create a file. I'm just going to set up a file name called spike XLSX, and I like to remove my files as I'm going through prototyping things. So every time I run these, it'll delete the file. Next up, I'll take that data, pipe it into ImportExcel to the file $XL file, and we'll do things like auto size, and I'm going to put it in, not in the standard A1 column, I'm going to put it at row 3, start in column 4, and then the key part, one of the key parts, is I will do a pass-through, which takes that created sheet, that workbook, and passes it back to PowerShell, which I'll store in Excel package. That object is basically access to the object model inside of Excel so that you can do a lot of cool things. So once that's done, I'm going to close the package and then I'm going to display the Excel file that we created. So first off, let's run this, see what we get. And it looks like a pretty standard, boring Excel sheet. We just dropped the data at an offset to the row, to the third row, and to the fourth column. And that's the data we had in CSV. And you can even see that the data, it's set up interestingly, but not to my liking. So we'll go to step two. We're gonna do exactly the same thing, except this time, instead of just exporting the data and then closing and showing it, we're gonna use set Excel range, okay? And I'm gonna do it on the worksheet, Excel package sheet one. If I don't name it on the export Excel, sheet one is used as a default. And then I'm going to go for the range of D3 to G3, which is basically these headers, right? This is going to be put in D3, E, F, and G. And I'm just going to bold the text and change the background color to light green, and I'm going to center it. So let's run that up. And we should see some nice headings, right? So there we go. Now we're going to go to step three. We're going to take care of this data here. We're going to colorize it, make it pop. So step three, same exact thing. We're going to just add another set Excel range. Same sheet, but this time we're going to do D4 to D15. Right? That's January through December. D4 to D15. And we're going to make that light blue. We're going to make it bold, and we're going to center it. Run that up. So now we're starting to get nice visuals. Here comes the cool part. Step four and the final step. Same stuff, except now we're gonna do one more set Excel range, and this one gets really interesting. And we're gonna do it from G3 to G15, and that's the change, right? 0.1, negative 0.0417. And we're gonna use this specialized custom number format that this, you can look it up in Excel, where I'm gonna set a color, I'm gonna set the formatting, and I'm going to use these characters to show what's increased, what's down in a range of data, and what hasn't changed. And this sets up a custom format that works along conditional formatting. I'll let you look that up. I'm just going to show you the effect of it. Okay, so let's pop this in. Here we go. And that's how we get this to be 10%, right? I think that's pretty cool. And notice, like, if there's no change, it actually calculates it. So that's Excel using that custom format to figure out what color to make it, as well as which icon to use. So to recap, we went from this, which is a simple export. We added three set Excel ranges in the end. to colorize the top and the left-hand column, and then do the cute little colorizations with the icons to get this. Install hyphen module, ImportExcel. Follow me on Twitter at DFINKE. And definitely, if you like what you see, thumbs up, subscribe. More is coming.